Good evening, good evening. Let me know where you're scoping in from tonight. I'm so excited to chat with you guys for a little bit. It is past the 9 o'clock hour, so I won't be on here forever. Hey, Trail. Hey, Katrina. Thanks, you ladies, for joining the scope. So tonight's going to be a juicy scope. I'm going to be talking about waiting on God. Thanks so much, Trail, for sharing. Long Daddy Aunt. Let me know who that is. Let me know where you're scoping in from. Thanks so much for joining the scope today. Hey, Demetria. Hey, Tiffany. Excited to see many of you tomorrow. I made it to South Carolina. Had a great time at the graduation. Hey, Quashonda. Thanks so much for joining the scope. You're from North Carolina. Okay. We're right close to North Carolina. I'm actually in South Carolina right now. So, all right, you guys. So I just want to share a little bit with you about waiting on God. Because if anybody got a testimonial about that, I definitely have a testimonial about that. And I just want to share a little bit to encourage you. For those of you that's part of the 21-day challenge, today we talk. It's, the message was, if he's a Christian, he must be God sent. Kind of going from the theory of sometimes it could be like a wolf dressed in sheep clothing, and we just have to be wary. We have to really just pay attention. So for those of you who aren't familiar with this and don't know even what the challenge is about, right now we're in the midst of a 21-day Fabulous Life Challenge, and we're just focusing on various areas of our life, from, you know, really just taking ownership of our time and our schedule, making sure we're spending time with God, making sure we're spending time taking care of ourselves. You know, trying to make sure we take care of ourselves and all of this extra good stuff, right? So that's what the 21-day challenge is about. Each day they get receive an email just to encourage you to make sure you're doing affirmations and all of that. So my name is Joe Bullock, and I'm one of the founders of Detour Movement, where we believe when you renew your mind, you transform your entire life, your entire life. So what I want to share with you today is that it's so important to wait on God. And let me just share with you a little bit of my journey, because I can remember, just from as long as I can remember, I always had a desire to be married, right? And if I had my own way, I would have married my high school sweetheart, right? I started dating him 10th grade, something like that. And as time went on, when I went off to college, because it came to a point that I was going to San Diego State. I was living in South Carolina, and I was trying to debate what school I wanted to go to, right? And it was a hard decision for me. Even though in San Diego I had a full scholarship, you know, seemed like they pretty much paved the way for me there, I hesitated to go there because I was so tied to this relationship. And I thought that this was the guy that I was to marry, even though it was an abusive relationship. Not so much physical abuse, but definitely a lot of mental abuse, a lot of emotional abuse. But had I had my way, I would have been with this guy. I would have married him. I mean, we stayed together for like 4 years, you know, but it wasn't the will of God. And so thankfully, God released me from that relationship. And, you know, but even from that point, that was probably, this is like 2000 to 2004-ish or so, 1999 to like 2003. So if I had my own way, I would have married him. That didn't work out. So, you know, it seemed like every relationship I got into, I was thinking, oh my God, is he the one? Is he the one? You know, always constantly thinking, is this the guy that God called me to marry? And then around, I would say 2007, I started to get discouraged. Like, I'm like, okay, I see, this is not working out. Like, I remember calling my auntie when she was alive at the time. She was over 70 years old, and she was a single woman, and she had never been married. And I called her, and I'm like, Auntie, when did you realize that you were just going to live a life of singleness? You know, and she just was sharing with me her story, and she was like, well, you know, it wasn't necessarily that I made a decision I was going to be single. This is the journey that God had for me, and this is the season I'm in. And she was definitely content in that season. But, you know, I share that so because at that point I was so discouraged because I didn't know how to wait on God. So thankfully, just over time, I started to realize that the decisions I was making and things I was doing was me conforming to the world, me trying to do what the world wanted me to do, me trying to really be something that I wasn't, and me not having the patience to just wait on God. right? I was choosing to constantly conform to what the world wanted me to do rather than wait on God. So I finally got to the point where I say, you know what? My way is not working. Let me just pause, halt, and try to really just wait on God and let's see what he does and see how he works things out for me. And thankfully, you know, God did work things out for me and I started to make better decisions and I had the boldness to make decisions to align my decisions with my values and with my beliefs, and I attracted that in my life and I ended up meeting and marrying my husband, who's an awesome man. You know, he's a man after the heart of God, and you know, I'm just really grateful for him. But see, at that time, I had to go through that experience. I had to go through all those different points. And I want to share a couple of points with you. I had to go through some of that so I can learn to appreciate that my husband for what he is now. Because had I not gone through some of those experiences, I would not have appreciated him. I just wouldn't have know how to appreciate him, because I had to kind of go through those lessons learned. And I just want to encourage you that if you feel like you're in a place that you're stuck, and it doesn't have to be a relationship, it could be in your business, it could be in a different area of your life, but if you feel like you are just in a season of waiting, you feel like you're stuck, you feel like you're not going, don't see your blessing coming, I'm just going to tell you to make sure you take advantage of learning the lessons that you need to learn. You know, that lesson may be patience, that lesson may be gratitude, that lesson may be learning how to submit. I mean, just so many things. But if you feel like you keep going through the same thing over and over and you're in a place of rut, it's because you have not learned the lesson you need to learn from that yet. Because once you learn that lesson, God will graduate you and elevate you to the next level. So make sure that you don't take this time and be spiteful or, you know, angry. Say, okay, God, there's something I need to learn in this moment, in this situation. Lord, reveal that thing to me so I can be ready for it. And that leads me to my second point, which is make sure you prepare yourself. Yes, you got to make sure. Yes, I told hubby I felt like was springing my wheels. Yes, yes. So, you know, it may be a lesson in that you definitely need to learn, and just try to listen to God. You know, when you pray, spend a few minutes just waiting and hear from him. And you may hear from him in that moment. You may hear from him at a different time of the day, just speaking through you, speaking through other people to you, or speaking through his word, just various ways that God will speak to you. So make sure you get that lesson. And this time, take advantage of preparing yourself. Take advantage of preparing yourself. There's so many things you can do in the season of preparation. I can remember in my journey when I was in a season of waiting, particularly for me, it was waiting for a husband. I spent time on my self-development. So I want to encourage you to spend time on developing who you are, right? I'm just not talking about on the outside. Spend time on the inside. Spend time getting to know you. Spend time dating yourself. You know, spend time, you know, just learning your spiritual journey. This is a great time for you just to really become one with God and constantly submit to him and grow and foster that relationship with him. And the last thing I want to tell you is just to make sure that you trust God. You know, one of the reasons why I end up reaching out to my aunt and be like, oh my God, is this ever going to happen for me? Is because I was losing trust. I was getting weary and, you know, I was kind of like, oh my God, is this ever going to happen? But I'm just going to tell you to trust God. You know, in Philippians 4:6, it says, be anxious for nothing, you know, but in through prayer and supplications, make your requests known to God. And also it tells you in the word, John 15:7, that if you abide in God and he abide in you, you ask what you desire and it shall be done for you. So I want to tell you to get that lesson that God has for you out of this. Take advantage of the lesson. Ask God, show me the lesson I need to learn in this moment. Prepare yourself. Use this season as preparation. As I had mentioned once before, you know, think about what Queen Esther, when she was going to marry the king, she spent 12 months a season of preparation. Your season may be 12 months. Your season may be 6 months or 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. I don't know. You don't know how long that season is, but use that time as preparation to get you to the next level of where God wants you to be. And then on that journey, just make sure you trust him. Like for real, trust him. Because if you don't trust him, sometimes you get to the temptation that you want to make your own blessing. You want to make your own blessing. But I'm going to encourage you, don't make your own blessing. If you can create your own blessing, or you can let God create your blessing, right? But you know he's all-knowing and he has all the answers. So his blessing is going to be 10 times better than any blessing that you or I can create for our own self. You know, and someone's posting also Ruth went a season of a preparation, you know, just learning to love and support on her mother-in-law, Naomi, when her husband had died. So we always go through transitions where we have to wait on God. Sometimes it's for a financial blessing. Sometimes it's for, you know, our husband. Yes. If you create your own blessing, then why will you need him? Exactly. And you know, God knows all the answers. We don't even have the half. He has the 2020 vision all the time, right? They always say hindsight is 2020. Yeah, but following God is 2020, right? So we just constantly have to do that. So I just wanted to peep in. I just wanted to share with you those three things about just spending that time to learn a lesson, spending that time as preparation, and just trust God in everything that you do. So I thank you all for joining the scope. I don't know if you guys had any questions or comments that you want to say before we hop off. If you do, go ahead and type it in. For those of you, while I wait for that, for those of you who may want to join the 21-day challenge, you still can join. We are going into day 12 tomorrow. It's thebiggestlieswomenbelieve.com. TheBiggestLiesWomenBelieve.com. Hey, is that Shelly? Hey there. Hey, Shelly. So glad you joined. So you can join there. If you also are in the South Carolina area, we invite you to come out to the book launch tomorrow. It's on the book, The Biggest Lies Women Believe, about men dating in themselves. And you can join us right at the Hyatt Hotel in Charleston. We'll be there from 6 to 8 p.m. tomorrow, and we're so excited. So you can go check that out. I believe you can RSVP at tinyurl.com, The Biggest Lies Live Event. tinyurl.com, The Biggest Lies Live Event. So thanks so much, you guys, for joining. Dimitri was just wrapping up, and you probably got kicked off. Periscope's a special. So anyway, ladies and gents that came on and check us out, thanks so much for joining this scope. Thank you, thank you, thank you. If you need to replay, you guys can replay once it goes off. And you know what? Now I love with replay. You know, you guys know you can fast forward and rewind. If you are single, dating, and mingling, or mingling, engaged, or married, you need to be at the live event. Come on out. Come on out. Come on out. So, yeah, it's going to have a great time. Come on out. You guys are so funny. Love you guys. Love you guys so much. So, yeah, just stay encouraged, you all who's on the journey, even if you've been have some stumbling on the 21-day challenge, you know, don't get discouraged. Do as much as you can. You know, just constantly put God first and then put yourself next to make sure you're taking care of yourself and just do the best you can. I know I've been loving doing the scheduling. It's really been helping me. The one thing that I said I do want to develop an intermittent time and doing certain things the same time of day. Because I kind of have created a routine in terms of, like, I like to walk during my lunch, you know, but it's not a specific time. And I kind of want to get a little, just tighten it up a little more on my scheduling just to make it a little more routine. Because that's where you really, yeah, routines are good for your life, like for real. Anyway, ladies, I'm not going to tarry tonight. Thanks so much for joining. Love you all to pieces. Thanks so much for all the hearts and showing all the love. Definitely appreciate the encouragement, the support. Keep pressing forward. There's so much greatness in you. God has something special in store for you. He sent you apart for a special time and a special person, if that's your heart's desire. So just don't get discouraged and know that He has something great for you. Do you know of a good book that teaches investments for women? You take me back. I used to, when I did investment for women, I'm thinking you're talking about financial investment. I'm thinking of Susie Orman's, which I know I don't necessarily believe with her personal values and beliefs, but financial, she has a lot of great things to say. And I'm trying to remember the name of the book that I have from her. I think it was Young, Fabulous, and Broke. Young, Fabulous, and Broke. And there's another lady, Singletary. I can't remember her first name. Michelle Singletary. She has a lot of good stuff. She's actually an African-American woman out of Maryland. And she has like this 21-day fast or challenge. I believe it's Michelle Singletary. You should be able to find her on Amazon. She got a lot of good stuff as well. So I would say either one of those ladies. The only thing with Susie Orman, I got to always give my little plug because I used to be a financial advisor. The only thing with Susie Orman, she discourages people from getting life insurance. And I believe that's true for people who are self-insured, who has like hundreds of thousands of dollars and don't necessarily need the assistance of an insurance company in the event of emergency. But I do believe that, I shouldn't say she don't believe in life insurance. She don't believe in permanent insurance. So you have to just kind of do what you think is best for you. But everybody have their different spin on insurance. But I definitely believe you should need to have some insurance, and permanent insurance you'll have it forever versus term. But anyway, wealthy people, yes, wealthy people don't need insurance, right? But if you want to make sure you cover your liabilities, no problem. Thanks so much for sticking tough with me tonight. You all have a great night, and I will see many of you tomorrow. And we are so excited. We got something special in store for you guys tomorrow. We're going to be keeping it 100, and I can't wait to see you guys. And you can grab a copy of the book if you like at jillbullock.com, JillBullock.com. Be blessed. Have a good night.